Hi friends, welcome to Digimento. So today onwards we'll be taking up the last 10 years questions. So we will see the last 10 years questions from unit 9. So we have finished unit 9 as of now. So we will be taking up the questions from unit 9, people, development and environment, which we have already completed. And the sources www.netugc.com. So I have taken the questions directly from the website itself. So the last 10 years questions from this particular module or from this particular unit will be taking up from today, but simultaneously in another 2-3 days I will start unit 10 also, and that previous year questions also we will discuss. So for now we will be starting with unit 9. Okay. If I am audible to you or if you are watching the classes and if everything is fine, please let me know. Say hi, hello in the comment box so that we can start. Hi Sumati, hi Ramesh, hi Rani. So we will wait for 2-3 more people to just log in and then start. Okay, hi Atira, hi Puri. So we will start now. Okay. If you have not yet subscribed to our channel, please do subscribe, and also please press the bell icon for receiving the notifications. And if you are preparing for GATE, NTA, UGC NET or PGT Computer Science, we are providing online courses which you can avail. You can visit our website www.digimentor.com or you can call to this number for more details. So we will start. Hi Pavitra. So yeah, this will be a kind of, you know, interactive session. Why? Because here we have already completed unit 9, so you have to give me the answers. Okay, for every question I'll give you 30 to 40 seconds of time depending upon the question. So you have to attempt, and after I get like at least 4-5 answers, then we will go to the answer. So let's start with 2010 June questions. So 2010 June month questions. Which type of natural hazards cause maximum damage to property and lives? So here the question is, among these four options, which among the natural hazards cause maximum damage to property and lives? So options are hydrological hazards, hydrometeorological hazards, geological and geochemical. So please tell me your answers. So you have 30 seconds of time. C, geological. Okay, let's see other options also. So let's see what others comment. A, hydrological. C, Sharma has commented C. Pavitra A. Any other answers? You can just attempt. Okay, so no issues, you can attempt. A, Pavitra has commented A. Okay, so any other answers? B, B, A, C. Okay, I think we'll see the answer. B is the answer. So Firdaus Sumati has commented B. Atira has also commented B. So hydrometeorological are the natural hazards which cause maximum damage to property and lives. Hi Lipika. Congrats. And those who have made it wrong also, congrats, because you have made an attempt and that's really worth it. Okay, so let's go to the next question. 2010 June again. Dioxins are produced from wasteland, power plants, sugar factories, combustion of plastics. Dioxins. I think we have already discussed this in the class regarding dioxins. Just try. Just try to answer. No problem, even if it goes wrong. D, 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 D. Okay. Let's see the answer. Combustion of plastics, correct answer. So congrats Pavitra, Arshad, Lipika, Firdos, Atira, everyone has commented the same. So I'm so happy. Okay. We have discussed this in the class, I think. So Atira, Sharma, Sumati Das. Okay, congrats. Next question. A slogan, a tree for each child, was coined for options: social forestry, clean air, soil conservation, environmental protection. So the slogan of a tree for each child. A, B, D. Let's see the other answers also. Come on. Everyone has to attempt, okay? I think 23 of you are now watching the classes live. So, all of you, I want all of you to answer. No, it's not like something, you know, there is no punishments, there is no negative marking. So, you can just attempt. Kanjan, first day in your class. Okay, Kanjan, but still you can try to attempt, okay? And PDFs are available on the Telegram channel, and the classes are also available. If you have time, you can watch them before the exam, Kanchan. So Sumati D, Pavitra A, Bhavna D. So most of you have gone for A and D. So let's see. A is the correct answer. Social forestry. A tree for each child, which means the participation. So for every child, one tree. So social forestry program. Social forestry, what is meant by social forestry? Forestry is becoming a part of the society, or protecting the forest, or afforestation becomes a part of the society. Okay. Kanchan has commented. Okay, definitely gonna watch all your classes. Thank you so much, Kanchan. Okay, if you need any help, you can reach to us. We will always be there to help you. And are you giving the exams this time, Kanchan? But anyways, we will be there for you, for all of you. Okay. So yeah, take it as a fun. So all these days, you know, last one and a half month, I think we are meeting for the last about like 40 days. So we were discussing this unit, and we were having some serious kind of classes. So take it as a fun. We will just try to solve it together. Okay. You're welcome, Kanchan. Okay. Mabel and Vijay. Vijay commented D, Mabel A. Let's try the next question. The main constituents of biogas. We have discussed this in the class, I'm sure. So you have to, I will not say you have to make it right, because this will create a pressure in you, but try to attempt. Main constituents of biogas: methane and carbon dioxide, methane and nitric oxide, methane, hydrogen, nitric oxide, methane and sulfur dioxide. So try to answer this. I want everyone to attempt this at least. I want everyone to attempt this, okay? A, okay. Okay, I think we will wait for some few more people to answer. Because this is a direct question from your class, I want everyone to answer. So A, everyone has gone for A. A is the right answer. Methane and carbon dioxide. I'm so happy, guys, because you are making it right. And I'm so happy we have discussed this in class and you have made it right. So A is the right answer. Yamini, don't worry, okay? No issues. So let's go for the next question. Now this is an assertion recent question, which means that the first statement, so two things are important here. I hope you have done this type of questions earlier also. So basically you have to see whether the first statement is correct, and also you have to see whether the second statement is individually correct, and also you have to see whether the second statement is the explanation of the first statement. So this is what you have to see here. In the world as a whole, the environment has degraded during the past several decades. Okay. Second one, reason: the population of the world has been growing significantly. So you have to see whether these statements are individually correct. Also, you have to see whether the second statement is the explanation of the first statement. So take your time and try to answer this. I want everyone to attempt this question. A, B, B, A, B, A, I think, but not 100% sure. Okay, that's okay, Kanjan. You can give an attempt. There is no harm in that. B, 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 A. Not because of population. A, A. So, most of you are confused between A and B. Let's see. B is the correct one. The population of the world has grown significantly, but environmental degradation, even though that is a cause, but that cannot be the major cause. Okay. The most significant cause. Next question. Climate change has implications for. So, the impact of climate change. This is what is asked. This also we have discussed in the class. I am sure you can answer that. Lipika has commented to explain this question. Okay, so this question, it's like in the world as a whole, that means globally, if we take, the environment has degraded. There is no doubt in that. So A, individually it's correct. Environment degradation has happened in the last several years or decades, but the population of the world has been growing significantly. We cannot say significantly because in many places the population growth is coming down. Okay. And also that even though population growth is there, but still that is not a major reason. Major reasons are many things related to anthropogenic activities, development, etc. And also the population growth in many countries have come down also. So that's why R is not the correct explanation of A. R is correct. Population growth is there. But we cannot say that is a major cause. So that is it. Now, the impact of climate change. So, climate change has its implications for soil moisture, forest fires, biodiversity and groundwater. So, which are the impacts of climate change? Okay, Lipika. Okay, Lipika. B, A, D, D, pass. Okay, pass. That's funny. Okay. Try to attempt. B, D, B. Okay. D, B. Okay. Let's see. B is the correct one. Okay, why groundwater is not there? When we discussed about groundwater, we have seen that the major reason for groundwater exploitation, or you know, the crisis with regard to groundwater is over exploitation, not climate change. So groundwater means beneath the surface. So it's mostly not climate change, but it is mostly the over exploitation. Okay. Next one, this is from 2010 December. So these were the questions asked in June. Okay, and now we'll come to 2010 December. Which of the following is not as important? Yesterday, I think yesterday we discussed about this. Not covered in 8 missions under the Climate Action Plan of Government of India. Do you remember yesterday we discussed about National Action Plan on Climate Change, and there we discussed 8 missions, 8 submissions. So first one is solar power, second one is waste to energy conversion, third is afforestation, D is nuclear energy. Tell me which one is the right answer. Mohit has sent me a high five. Okay. Mabel has commented D. D, 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 D. Okay, I'm so happy. Let's check. D is the correct answer. This was a very direct question from yesterday's lecture. I'm so happy for you. D, 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 D. Hi, Mohit. Namaste. So, I'm so happy. Vandana, it's okay. Next time, we'll make it right. Okay? Atira, very good. So, congrats to everyone who attempted. So, okay, it takes a, you know, courage to attend the question also. So, it's okay. Next one, we'll see. The concentration of total dissolved solids in drinking water should not exceed total dissolved solids in the drinking water. This is to measure the pollution level in the drinking water. Concentration of total dissolved solids in drinking water should not exceed 500 mg per liter, 400, 300 and 200. So Arshad has missed yesterday's class. It's okay, Arshad. It's available on YouTube. You can watch them, many of the 400. C, C, B, A, D, C, C. Okay, different answers are coming up because this is a factual question. It can go wrong. So let me see. 500. I think nobody has commented 500. That's okay. Sometimes, you know, you may get some factual questions also. It's not that you can attempt all the questions, but sometimes you will get such kind of factual questions. It's okay. Some questions maybe you cannot attempt also, so that's okay. Okay, I guess 500, Sumati said. Yeah, and that's right, your guess was correct, Sumati. Now next one. Okay, this is this Chipko movement we discussed in the class. Chipko movement was first started by Arundhati Roy, Medha Patkar, Ila Bhatt and Sundarlal Bahuguna. So I hope you can answer this. Let's see. D. D. Okay. Yes. D is the right answer. That's it, okay. Next question. The constituents of photochemical smog responsible for eye irritation. If you remember, we discussed about photochemical smog and the classic smog. And we also discussed what are the components of photochemical smog, what are the components of classic smog. So here the question is a little indirect. It's asking the constituents responsible for eye irritation in case of photochemical smog. It's just that you need to know what are the constituents of a photochemical smog. We have already completed this in the class. So can you tell me? Das has asked me about explaining the Chipko movement. I'll come to it, Das. After this question, we'll see that. B. Most of you are going for B. Any more answers? C. Let's see. C is the answer. Okay. Now, before next question, let me explain to you about the Chipko movement. We have already explained. So, Chipko movement was a kind of environmental conservation movement where when this, in the name of developmental activities, when this forest was about to cut, the women in this forest area, they came and hugged the trees and so this movement, it was led by Sundarlal Bahuguna. So yeah, it's an environmental conservation program. Next one, some carbonaceous aerosols may be carcinogenic, which means some aerosols which has carbon compounds can be carcinogenic. Carcinogenic means causing cancer. Now this is the assertion. Reason, they may contain polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons. Kanchan has commented, "Maine ye class pehle kyun nahi ki? You are so awesome and cute. Thank you and sorry for." It's okay, Kanchan, and thank you so much for the message. A. Okay. So A, you are going for A. Try to attempt. Anybody else? Any other answers? A. Okay. A is the right answer. So good job. Next question. Volcanic eruptions affect atmosphere and hydrosphere, hydrosphere and biosphere, lithosphere, biosphere and atmosphere, lithosphere, hydrosphere and atmosphere. So by this time, I hope you know what is atmosphere, what's hydrosphere, what's biosphere and what's lithosphere. So please try to answer. Lipika, it's okay. With practice, we can make it perfect, Lipika. Don't worry. Once we finish the previous years, I think you will be more comfortable. D, B, D, 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 C. Let's see. D is the correct answer. Lithosphere, hydrosphere, and atmosphere. Okay, I think most of you have gone for D. So we'll start with 2011 June. We'll try to finish 2011 also today, so that tomorrow we will finish 12 and 13. Okay. Lipika has asked me why not bio. Bio, because bio, what is biosphere? It's where all these three other components meet. So that's why. Now the Ganga Action Plan was initiated during the year 1986, 1988, 1990, and 1992. 86. Okay. Any other answers? A. A, okay. A is the right answer. 1986 is the right answer. Okay. Next. Identify the correct sequence of energy sources in order of their share in the power sector. So you have to identify what is the correct sequence of energy sources in the order of the share in power sector. So there are four options: thermal, nuclear, hydro and wind. So which one constitutes the major share in the order of that, you have to identify. C, hydro, nuclear, thermal, wind. Okay, let's see. C. B, A. Okay, let's see. B is the correct answer. So thermal power is the largest source of power sector in India. So this is a very important question. So the sequence of energy sources in the order of their share in the power sector. So this is a very important question. Okay, if you do not know this, please write down. So whatever I say important, it's important, because this question can be asked in any way, like which one is the largest contributor to the power sector. So thermal, hydro, nuclear and then wind. So thermal, hydro, you can make your codes also for that. Okay. Chromium as a contaminant in drinking water is in excess of permissible limit causes. So the question is, if in drinking water there is a high level of chromium that is beyond the permissible level, then it will lead to skeletal damage, gastrointestinal problem, dermal and nervous problems, liver kidney problems. क्रोमियम, क्रोमियम, बी बी डी डी, ओके, ओके, बी डी बी, हेवी मेटल, ओके, डी सी बी, लेट्स सी, बी स्किन सॉलिड मेटल, डी 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 डी, ओके, लेट्स सी, सी डर्मल एंड नर्वस प्रॉब्लम्स, ओके, सो व्हेन यू गेट दिस क्वेश्चन क्रोमियम देन इट्स रिलेटेड टू लिवर एंड सॉरी डर्मल एंड नर्वस प्रॉब्लम्स. Now, the main precursors of winter smog. Again, the question is related to smog, winter smog. N2O and hydrocarbons, NOx and hydrocarbons, SO2 and hydrocarbons, SO2 and ozone. Remember, last year also the same question was again repeated. So, this is a repeated question. So, it's important. Okay. And that's why I took a detailed class about the smog session. So, different types, constituents, etc. Pavitra is asking me for Telegram ID. Can someone share the Digimento Telegram ID here? We have four channels, Pavitra. One is Digimento, so you can join that. That's the main channel. So there are some batch-wise channel also. Somebody please do share the names. And my personal Telegram channel is Joycy Joy Official. JOICYJOY Official. So A, C, C, C. Let's see. B is the answer. NOx and hydrocarbons. Okay. Flash floods. Flash floods are caused when atmosphere is convectionally unstable and there is considerable vertical wind shear. When the atmosphere is stable, the atmosphere is convectively unstable and with no vertical wind shear, winds are katabatic. I think we have not discussed about flash floods. So I'll take it up. Okay. Thank you, Pavitra. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you so much. We will discuss about the flash floods. What I'll do is whatever questions, you know, we haven't discussed, I'll just write it down. And tomorrow we will, whenever we discuss a question, whichever topic is coming in, which we have not discussed in class, we will take it up tomorrow, okay? So, flash floods. So, tomorrow I'll take this topic in detail. So, that also we will do. The atmosphere is convectively unstable and there is considerable vertical wind shear. So tomorrow we will take this topic in detail. So whichever we have missed in the class, we will take it up. Okay. Next question. In mega cities of India, the dominant source of air pollution. So we are talking about mega cities in India. Like for example, Delhi, Bombay, Bangalore, Calcutta, so all these are mega cities. In mega cities of India, the dominant source of air pollution. We have discussed this in the class. This is a direct question. A, okay. C, A. A, most of you. Okay. C, municipal waste. I think we have discussed this directly in the class. No. Jenny has commented, please take paper 2 computer science. I'm not from computer science background. I'm sorry, Jenny. But I think some other faculty will be covering it. Don't worry about it. Okay. This was a direct question. That's okay. Next question. So we are taking up 2011 December. Okay, this is from December 2011. Which of the following pollutants affects the respiratory tract in humans? Carbon monoxide, nitric oxide, sulfur dioxide, aerosols. This is also a direct question. I hope you remember when we discuss about this topic, I told you most of the pollutants affect the respiratory tract, but there is one particular pollutant which is very much dangerous for the respiratory tract and also can cause respiratory diseases. If you can recollect that particular pollutant, definitely you can answer this. So you are commenting D, Shreya, Sanchari. Let's see some other answers as well. B, okay. C is the answer, sulfur dioxide. Which of the following pollutants is not emitted from the transport sector? So which one is not emitted from transport sector? This is the question. B. Okay. B, 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 B. Okay. A. Okay. B is the answer. Why? Because we have already discussed chlorofluorocarbons, which are present in refrigerators and air conditioners. They affect the ozone. So we have discussed that. Next question. Which of the following sources of energy has the maximum potential in India? Potential. We are talking about the potential. Solar, wind, ocean thermal, and tidal. C, C, A, B, C. Potential, okay. Solar. I stress the word potential because thermal energy, definitely we are already utilizing it, but we are talking about the potential which has to be explored, which has to be now used. So it's A, solar energy. Okay. Which of the following is a source of pollution in soil pollution? Transport sector, agricultural sector, thermal power plants, hydropower plants. This is a very direct question. We have discussed in the class already when we discussed about soil pollution. I think you can answer this. I'm sure you can answer this. C, B, A. Okay, any other answers? B, 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 B. C, agri, B, transport, A. B is the answer, agriculture, because soil pollution is hugely related to agricultural sector. Next, which of the following is not a natural hazard? So which one is not a natural hazard? This is a very direct question, very simple question. So earthquake, tsunami, flash floods, nuclear accident. Which one is not natural? Very direct. D, 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 D. Okay. I want everyone to answer this. This is such a simple question. D, 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 D. Nuclear. Okay. Let's see. Nuclear. Okay, this is very simple. Next, ecological footprint. What is meant by ecological footprint? This is also a direct question. We discussed this question when we discussed about the basics of ecology and environment. So I want you to answer this. Ecological footprint represents area of productive land and water to meet the resources required, एनर्जी कंजम्पशन, सीओ टू एमिशंस पर पर्सन, फॉरेस्ट कवर. दिस इज वेरी डायरेक्ट. अगेन यू विल सी इकोलॉजिकल फुटप्रिंट एवरीवेयर इन द न्यूज. A, okay. B, A. A, B. We'll see. A is the answer. Area of productive land and water to meet the resource requirement. Every time you will hear about carbon footprint. What is carbon footprint? CO2 emissions per person. Ecological footprint means area of productive land and water to meet the resource requirement. Okay. Next is 2012 June. I am not starting it today. Why? Because if we start, we may not be able to complete it today. Then we may have to just stop. Sorry. Okay, sorry. So we may have to just, you know, stop it in between. So tell me, how was the session today? We will wind up today. So 2 years we have taken today. Tomorrow we will try to cover 3 years papers. Okay. So tell me, how did the paper go and how was your experience? Maybe you might have gone wrong in many questions, but that's absolutely fine. Attempting is the best thing, and remember one thing, the most important thing is that this mock test is where you have to make mistakes, because in the real exam you will not commit the same mistakes. So this is a trial. You can say that this is where you can make errors, you can try make errors, and in the real exam you can do really well. So this is where you can make mistakes. So that's absolutely fine if you have gone wrong with the answers. Tomorrow definitely you will see that you will improve. Okay, so we just began today. Tomorrow definitely you will improve, and in the coming days I'm sure that you are going to do really well, and towards the examination you will do really really well for the exam. So how was the session today? Very good, nice, awesome. Very nice, nice. New join today. The class is amazing. Thank you. But confusion, ma'am, in many questions. Okay, thank you. Thank you so much for the very good feedback that you have given me. So Das has commented confusion in many questions. So that's okay. Tomorrow you will feel, you know, better, more confident to answer. Then in the coming days you will definitely improve. Take my word, you will definitely improve. Subia attended first class, but it's very good. So if you all like this video, please do share this video with your friends so that they will also be benefited, and tell your friends also to join the classes tomorrow, because other classes they can watch, that's fine, but this question answer session and, you know, mock test and all, it's important to attend, and they attend the questions, then only they will remember. Otherwise it will be kind of boring for them. So ask them to join the classes from tomorrow. Okay, Senthil has commented, it gives me confidence. Recall about your class. Yes, and tomorrow do revise and come. Okay, so you will answer more number of questions. I have joined in the last 10 minutes, but it's effective. Thank you, JD. And Atira, the questions will repeat. Yes, you have seen, no? Smog and all, every time there is at least one question from smog. So questions will repeat also. Where are CS paper 2? I'm not sure about the computer science classes. Can you just check the Telegram channel for that? So I think we will wind up today here. I wish you all the very best. Tomorrow we will meet again, but make sure you have revised make sure that you know, you start attending the session from the beginning itself from tomorrow, and share this video, and also tell your friends to join the classes from tomorrow. So we will meet again tomorrow 7:30. the same time for 1 hour. Maybe tomorrow I'll take the session for 1 hour. Today I thought of taking for a little more time, but I'm really sorry because my daughter is sick and I can hear her crying from outside. Like, she started crying at some 7:30 or after 5-10 minutes after we began the classes, she started crying and I can hear that she's sick. So I need to go. I'm really sorry. I thought of taking the classes till 8:30, but really sorry because this is the situation. So I'm really sorry. So I'll just go and take care of her and I'll meet you tomorrow. Okay, so take care. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye. Hello friends, welcome to DigiMento. So if I'm audible to you, please let me know, because last time when I started the streaming, there was some issues with the YouTube network and all. So if I'm audible to you, please let me know. And if you are watching the video also, let me know. Okay. So yeah, if you're watching the video, let me know. If you are live, and if there is some technical issue that you're facing, then also let me know. Because when I started to stream it, it was not coming. So yeah, let me know. Okay, now we'll start. Yesterday we started with the previous year questions, and we already finished 2 years, that is 2010 and 11. So we were discussing only unit 9, people, development and environment. So let's continue that. Please do let me know your comments here in the comment section. Okay. Hi Puviri, hi Senthil, hi Yakub, hi Rani. Rani has commented, now you can hear me, now it's audible. Okay, so last time I don't know what happened, there was some technical issue I think with the YouTube, not from our end or from the DigiMento team, or not even from my side. Network was, everything was fine. I think there was some issues with the YouTube, so yeah, that's why it was not proper last time. Sorry for the delay. I think we got delayed by like 15 minutes. So yeah, if you have not yet subscribed to our channel, please do subscribe to our channel and also press the bell icon for receiving the notifications. If you are preparing for GATE, NTA, UGC NET or PGT Computer Science, you can avail our online courses. You can visit our website www.digimento.com or you can call to this number for more details. So yeah, we will just start. So till yesterday we finished the 2010 and 11 question papers. Okay, we will start with 2012 today. Yeah, okay. Yeah, Kub is asking me, is the paper pattern same? Yes, because this is the previous year paper only, so it's the same. Okay, so if there is any issue, let me know. Okay, I'll just tell the team that, convey that to the team. Okay, so if everything is okay now, if there is no issues, if I'm audible to you and if everything is okay, let me know. Okay, so that we will start. Hi Das, is everything fine at your end? Let me know if everything is okay, so that we will just start. So those who are watching, please let me know. Okay, everything is fine, so we will start. First question from 2012 June. Irritation in eyes is caused by the pollutant. Which pollutant causes irritation in the eyes? Everything is okay. Okay. So which pollutant causes irritation in the eyes? Das has commented C. Okay. Let's wait for other comments. C C A C C. Okay. Hi Atira. Hi Gajalakshmi. A C. Let's see. See, pan is the answer. Next one, which is a source of chlorofluorocarbons? This is a very simple question. I think I have discussed this at least 10 times in the class. So, which is the source of chlorofluorocarbons? Thermal power plants, automobiles, refrigeration, air conditioning. Refrigeration and air conditioning, fertilizers. Very simple question. So, Puvi has commented C, Nainika C, JD C. I need everyone to answer this. Very simple question. Even though you go wrong, that's okay. I want everyone. Sujata C, okay. Rahman C, Sumati C, Sayama C. Okay, let's see. See, refrigeration and air conditioning. And we also know that chlorofluorocarbons are responsible for ozone layer depletion. We discussed it many times in the class. So, ozone layer depletion. Okay. Nitya, Roslin, everyone has commented. See. So, these three things remember. Chlorofluorocarbons, the source is refrigeration, air conditioning, and it leads to ozone layer depletion. Now, which of the following is not a renewable natural source? Which of the following is not a renewable natural resource? So, which one is not renewable? Renewable means we can replenish them in a short period of time. So, which among this is non-renewable? Clean air, fertile soil, fresh water, salt. D, B, D, D. More answers. D, B, D. D, D. Okay, let's see. D is the answer. Okay. Clean air, fertile soil, fresh water, etc. are renewable. Now you may ask me, then why we are not like, if there is a pollution in the city, why we are not able to regain it back? Fresh air, why we cannot regain it? Or if there is some pollution, soil pollution, why we are not able to regain it back? Now, if there is water pollution, why we are not able to regain it back? The answer, the very simple answer is that the human activities are still continuing. I'll just give you an example to illustrate it. Now, during the months of April, in the last month, week of March, we announced, or the Prime Minister announced, the national lockdown. The country announced the national lockdown. So, in the month of April and even in the month of May, we had the national level lockdown. Now, what happened during the national level lockdown? The economy was completely shut down, except some essential services were allowed. So, during this month, what happened? The vehicles on the roads came down, the industrial activities came down. As a result, what happened? The air became cleaner. Okay? The air became purer. So, clean air, fertile soil, fresh water, everything will renew if we give them a time to replenish. But we are not doing that. What we are doing, we are still continuing to pollute them. So, the rate of pollution is increasing day by day, not because they are not renewable, it is because of the human activities which are still continuing. So, that is the answer. Next one, which of the following parameters is not used as pollution indicator in water? So, which among the following is not used as a pollution indicator in water? Okay, total dissolved solid, coliform count, dissolved oxygen, density. Which one is not used as a pollution indicator? So, which among these parameters cannot be said as, or cannot be used as a pollution parameter to know about the intensity of water pollution? So, this is a little confusing, but you can answer it. Try to do it. D, D. डी 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 ओके लेट्स सी डी इज द आंसर ओके वेरी गुड नेक्स्ट एस एंड पी वेव्स आर एसोसिएटेड विद वेरी 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 सिंपल क्वेश्चन वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इट इन द क्लास सो आई एम श्योर यू कैन आंसर इट एस एंड पी वेव्स आर एसोसिएटेड विद फ्लड विंड एनर्जी अर्थक्वेक टाइडल एनर्जी सी डी सी 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 ओके एनी मोर आंसर्स डी डी सी ओके लेट्स चेक द आंसर सी अर्थक्वेक सो व्हेन वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट अर्थक्वेक वी सेड दैट देर आर पी वेव्स सरफेस वेव्स एंड बॉडी वेव्स देन अगेन क्लासिफाइड इनटू एस वेव्स एंड पी वेव्स ओके अर्थक्वेक Next one, you have to match the following. Match list 1 and 2 and select the correct answer from the quotes given below. Okay? Ozone hole. So, what is it related to? Greenhouse gas effect. Then, natural hazards. Sustainable development. So, tell me, ozone hole, which one it is related to? Greenhouse gas effect, which one it is related to? Then natural hazards and then sustainable development. Take some time, think about it. And even if you do not know all the four options, let me know which one you know. Okay. A. Okay, A. A. Most of you are going for A. Okay, A is the correct one. Now, we know that ozone hole, it's related to UV radiation. The very purpose of ozone in the atmosphere is to protect us from the ultraviolet radiation. So, ozone hole is related to UV radiation. Greenhouse gas effect. Methane is a greenhouse gas. Tsunami is a natural hazard. And sustainable development, it's related to ecocentrism. Okay. Next one. Which of the following is a source of methane? So, methane. Which one is a source of methane? Methane is a greenhouse gas. So, which are the source? Which among the following is a source of methane? We have discussed it in the class. So, I am sure you will be able to answer it. A. Wetland. B. Farm industry. C. Thermal power plants. D. Cement industry. Methane wetlands, C, A, C, okay. I am waiting for more answers. I am talking little slowly today because I have a very, very severe throat pain today. So, if I am not audible to you, let me know so that I will talk little more louder. If I am audible, then I will continue this like this. So, let me know if I am not audible, okay. A, C, B. Okay, there are multiple answers coming up. Methane. We are talking about methane. Okay. So, I think we will check the answer now. Wetlands. So, major source of methane is wetlands. Okay. If I am audible to you, as I told you, I am talking very slowly today. Otherwise, I used to talk a little more louder. So, if I am audible to you, let me know. Or else I can talk a little more louder, okay? Okay, audible. Thank you so much. Thank you. Now, Minamata disaster in Japan was caused due to the pollution of. We have discussed it and I remember I gave you a trick to remember this, how you can connect Minamata. So, that is the clue for you. So, Yeah, Minamata disaster. It was caused due to pollution of lead, mercury, cadmium, zinc. Now, okay, I'll tell you why we are taking this test. Now, when I taught you about Minamata, I told you how you can remember it, how you can remember the pollutant. I gave you a trick. Maybe some of you might have forgotten because you have a lot number of things to remember. Now, if you go wrong here, you will never forget it in your lifetime. I promise you. Because whenever I have done a, previously I have done a mock test, and then after the mock test, whenever I have made a mistake, I'll never make it wrong in the real exam. So M to M, M, M. Okay, M, M. Okay, I'm so happy you are even remembering the trick also that I gave. And not trick actually, it's just a, you know, code that you can remember. M, M, Minamata disaster. Okay, Minamata is related to mercury. Okay, so okay, everyone has made it right. Now, biomagnification. This also, I think at least 10 times in the class, we have discussed about biomagnification. So, biomagnification means the means increase in the concentration of pollutants in living organisms, number of species, size of living organisms, biomass. So, what is it related to? Biomagnification. Okay, biomagnification. I'll give you a clue. It's related to food chain. Hi Neetu, where were you yesterday? I did not see you yesterday. Where were you? And even I asked that, like, I did not see you. So, yeah. A. Okay. The answer is A, concentration of pollutants in living organisms. I hope you remember, we discussed it in the class several times. So answer is concentration of pollutants, and we have also discussed how it happens through the food chain. Okay. Nagoya Protocol. Again, this is a direct question from the class. That's why I said if you have attended the classes, then very less chances that you will make all these things wrong. So I prepared the classes or the material, the PPTs, based on the previous year papers only. So I'm sure you can make most of the questions right. So Nagoya Protocol, it's related to climate change, ozone depletion, hazardous waste, biodiversity. Hello friends, and welcome to Digimento. So let's begin today's session. If you are attending the classes, please do let me know. So we were discussing the paper UGC NET last 10 years question paper, the questions from the unit 9 which we completed, that is people, development and environment. So if you are watching the classes, please do let me know. Okay, so yeah, I hope you are watching the classes. Yesterday there was some problem with the YouTube. I don't know what went wrong. I was not able to continue the classes, and then I was not able to stream. It was getting disconnected. So yeah, so I think we will start now. If you are attending the classes, please do let me know so that I can just start the session. So I'm not able to get the live comments. I'm just looking for it. Okay. So if you're watching the classes, let me know. Okay. Yeah, let's start. And if you are not yet subscribed to our channel, UGC NET, NTNet Computer Science, please do subscribe to the channel and also press the bell icon for receiving the notifications. And also, if you are preparing for GATE, NTA, UGC NET or PGT Computer Science, you can avail our online courses. You can visit our website www.digimentor.com or call to this number for getting more details about the same. So yeah, so we will just start. I don't know what happened, but I'm not able to get the comments here. The live comments I'm not able to get anyway. Let's see. Okay, so let's start with. So I think we have already finished 2010 and 11 day before yesterday. Yesterday we were taking up 2012. So let's see. So all these questions we have finished. Now I think we will start with Nagoya Protocol. So because yesterday some of the questions I think you were not, even though I was taking the classes, I think a few questions you were not able to answer because of the issue. So if you are attending the classes, let me know. Hi Rani, hi Senthil, hi Puvidi. Others, please let me know so that we will just start with the session. So we will just start with, let the others also join. So let's start. Nagoya Protocol is related to options, climate change, ozone depletion, hazardous waste, biodiversity. So what is Nagoya Protocol related with? Hi Preeti. So yeah, please tell me your answers. Only four. If others have joined the class, let me know. Send me a hi or hello so that yeah. Rani has commented D. I think yesterday we have discussed this question, but I am not sure whether you were able to get it. Because yesterday there were some technical issues with the YouTube. It was not that issue from our side. So yeah, D. So answer is D, biodiversity. Next one. The second most important source after fossil fuels contributing to India's energy needs. The second most important source after fossil fuels contributing to India's energy needs. Okay. Solar, nuclear, hydropower, wind energy. So I think this question indirectly we have discussed yesterday. Yesterday or day before yesterday when we were discussing about the sources of energy, I think we discussed about it. So the second most important source after fossil fuels contributing to India's energy needs. Solar, nuclear, hydropower or wind energy. Answers, please give me the answers. And why only very less people today? Hi Sumati, hello. So C, hydropower. Okay. Any other answers? B is nuclear energy. Okay. So any others? Any other answers? A, C. A is solar. C is hydropower. Let's check. Hydropower is the answer. Yesterday or the day before yesterday we have discussed this, but indirectly. Solar energy is the potential, means it's not the contributing factor. We have huge potential, but it is unexplored to a larger extent. So that is why solar energy is not the answer. If the question was about the potential, then solar energy was definitely there. But now the thing is, we have the potential, but utilization is very less. Okay. Next. In case of earthquake, an increase of magnitude 1 on Richter scale implies. Okay, so just revise or recollect. We discussed about the Richter scale. Okay, in case of earthquakes, an increase of magnitude 1 on the Richter scale implies a tenfold increase in the amplitude of seismic waves, a tenfold increase in the energy of seismic waves, a twofold increase in the amplitude of seismic waves, a twofold increase in the energy of seismic waves. So which one is correct? An increase of magnitude 1 on Richter scale. What is basically Richter scale? Can someone tell me in the comment section what is Richter scale? What does it measure? No answers. A. Okay. We studied about two scales of measuring the earthquake, Richter scale and Mercalli scale. So can someone tell me what is the difference between both of them? Okay, Sumati has commented to measure the earthquake. That's correct. But we have two scales. That is, one is Richter scale, the other one is Mercalli scale. So tell me, what's the difference? Neetu, measure of energy. Okay. Okay. Hi, Atira. Senthil has commented, okay, scale between 0 to 10. Okay. So, in case of an earthquake, an increase of magnitude 1 on Richter scale, what does it mean? Okay, we'll just check the answer. A tenfold increase in the amplitude of seismic waves. Now, if this question is not clear for you, I am not going to explain it now. The reason is that many of you still have a confusion between Richter scale and Mercalli scale and all that. So, please do go back and revise your classes on earthquake. So, tomorrow we will have a discussion on this question. I am writing down the important ones that you have missed out, like flash floods. We had a confusion day before yesterday. So, everything together I will take up towards the end of the session, but you have to revise it, okay, from your side. Next question. Kyoto Protocol is related to, this is also a very direct question, we have discussed about Kyoto Protocol. So Kyoto Protocol is related to ozone depletion, hazardous waste, climate change, nuclear energy. So Kyoto Protocol is related to, which is the answer? Lab Singh has asked me, does the class take place every day? Yes, every day we have a live session at 7:30. C. Okay, Das has commented A. Okay, so let's check the answer. This is a very simple question. Answer is C. Kyoto Protocol is related to climate change. Okay. Which of the following, now we have started 2013 June paper. Which of the following is a source of emissions leading to eventual formation of surface ozone as a pollutant? Now the question is little tricky. You have to be very careful. Which of the following is a source of emission leading to eventual formation of surface ozone as a pollutant? Surface ozone. So transport sector, refrigeration and air conditioning, wetlands, fertilizers. So which among this forms surface ozone, and the surface ozone is a pollutant. Okay. Now what did we say about the ozone? If the ozone is found in the atmosphere, then it is good because it will protect us from the ultraviolet radiation. Now ozone found in the, ozone is nothing but molecules of oxygen, three molecules. So if it's found in the surface of the earth, then this is a pollutant. And which is the source of ozone in the surface? Many answers are there. A, B, transport, A. I think you have to like, okay, let's see. So yeah, any other answers? Transport sector. So why do you need a confusion? We have already discussed this in the class if you remember. Okay. Next question. The smog in cities in India is mainly consisting of. This also is a direct question from the class. oxides of sulfur, oxides of nitrogen and unburned hydrocarbons, carbon monoxide and SPM, oxides of sulfur and ozone. B, D, okay. Any other answers? Hi, Yakub. B, A, okay. B, D, A, okay. Answer is B, oxides of nitrogen and unburned hydrocarbons. Yesterday also same question was there, nitrogen and hydrocarbons. Which of the following types of natural hazards have the highest potential to cause damage to human beings? So the question here is, which of the following is the natural hazard which can cause the highest potential or which has the highest potential to cause damage to the human beings? Options are earthquake, forest fire, volcanic eruption, droughts and floods. So it's very easy. If you can just apply your brain, you can get the answer. So actually, can I find all the classes in playlist? Yes, it's there. All the classes are there in the playlist lab. And Das has asked me SPM. It's suspended particulate matter. Okay. Now I'm getting a lot of different answers for this question. C, D. D, C, D, A, A. Okay. Why no B? Forest fires. Okay, I'll come to the answer. Answer is D, droughts and floods. How you can eliminate is earthquake. Definitely it has a potential of causing damage to the human beings, but the area is restricted. Now in case of forest fires, it mainly happens in forest, therefore lesser human damage. Volcanic eruptions also, the area is very less. Now droughts and floods, it affects a large area. Okay. Now, the percentage share of renewable energy sources in power production in India is around. Now, I don't think this question is relevant now because this question was asked in the year 2013. And in 2014-15 period, the International Solar Alliance was framed, and also that we had renewed targets of renewable energy sources. So I don't think this question is relevant for you now, but still I saw this question, so I added. I don't think it's relevant. Also the numbers have definitely changed after 2015 and all. We have tremendously increased our share of renewable energy. So the answer is 10 to 12%, but right now also we do not have the adequate data regarding it, because as we discussed, we have many targets, but the targets are only progressing, they are not achieved. So I don't think this question is relevant now. Next is, by the year 2022, the Climate Change Action Plan of Government of India aims at installing 20,000 megawatts of wind power, 25,000 megawatts of wind power, 20,000 megawatts of solar power, 10,000 megawatts of solar power. So, which one? Yash has asked me about Kaushik sir, Himanshu sir. He is doing well. He will definitely meet you soon. Okay. D, B. Okay. Any other answers? Okay. C is the answer. Yes, that's 20,000 megawatts of solar power. Okay. Which one of the following biosphere reserve has UNESCO recognition? This also we have discussed in class. Okay. लव वाई सॉरी इट्स ओके ओके this type of revision for paper 2 paper 2 I cannot do that but I'll definitely tell the team to do one such okay this we have discussed in the class which among the following biosphere reserves has UNESCO recognition Manas Kanchenjunga Seshachalam Great Nicobar I hope you remember we discussed about all the biosphere reserves under the MAB man biosphere reserve program so Any other answers? Roslyn, you're welcome. Any other answers? A. Manas. Okay. Answer is Great Nicobar. So this is has got the UNESCO recognition. Okay. Okay. Which activity contributes to water pollution more than any other throughout the world? So at the global level, this is also a question that we have discussed already. If you remember, we conducted a small test after finishing like 4 or 5 chapters modules. So can you recollect which activity contributes to water pollution more than any other throughout the world? Agriculture, hydroelectric power generation, industry, urbanization. It's not about depletion. It's this term pollution is very important. Okay, pollution. So here the question is pollution, not depletion. So which activity contributes to water pollution more than any other throughout the world? C, C, A. Okay. Any other answers? Any other options? Industry. C, C, A. Okay. A is the answer. Agriculture. Okay. I told you I have discussed this question already. Yes, agriculture. Now, be very careful. Okay. You can definitely answer this because this is also a direct question from what we have discussed in the class. Because we discussed about the location of different biosphere reserves. Okay. Now, first one is Nilgiri. You have to find out where is Nilgiri from the following. Deccan Peninsula, Chhattisgarh, Eastern Himalaya or Western Ghat. Then we have the Manas Biosphere Reserve, Simlipal and Achankamar Amarkandak. So, if you at least know, I think two of them, you can answer this. At least, I think if you know one also, you can answer. D, okay. Any other answer? At least if you know one, you can answer. Okay. So, if Nilgiri is in Western Ghats, then you can definitely answer this question. So, D, 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 okay. Obvious answer D. Nilgiri is in Western Ghats. Manas is in Assam. So it belongs to Eastern Himalayas. So Nilgiri is in Western Ghats. Then we have the Manas National Park or the Biosphere Reserve in Eastern Himalaya. Actually the location of Manas is in Assam. So Manas Biosphere Reserve was located in Assam. Then we have Simlipal. Then which is Deccan Peninsula. And we have the Achankamar Amarkandak in Chhattisgarh. Okay. Which of the following nations has the maximum per capita emissions of carbon dioxide? Maximum per capita. So this is important. What is meant by per capita? So how to find per capita emission? Total emissions divided by population. So emissions divided by population will give you per capita carbon emissions. So which of the following nations has the maximum per capita emissions of carbon dioxide? Emissions divided by population. Now you have to remember, when the denominator increases, what will happen? Okay. So, any other answers? No idea. A, D, D, D. Okay. Answer is C. I gave you a clue. Per capita. Suppose, for example, I'll give you an illustration. Suppose the pollution, suppose all these four countries, suppose all these four countries has a pollution of 100 units, suppose, okay? But the population in these countries are different. China has a population of 100, so per capita emission is 1 unit. Japan has a population of 20, let's say. So 100 divided by 20 is 5. So US, suppose it has the least population, not, I'm just giving you an illustration, okay? Suppose 10, so per capita is 10. Now, India has a population of, let's take 8. So, no, not 8, 80. So, it will be somewhere around 1 point something, okay? So, how you can eliminate in this case? You know, China and India are the most populous countries. So, China and India will not come, because this question is about per capita emission. Even though the emission rate is high, when it is calculated on the basis of per capita, then definitely it comes down. So, the only remaining option is Japan and USA, and it's very easy to eliminate Japan from there. Okay. Oh yeah, Sumati, yes, I told you it in the class. Hello, hi Surbhi. Okay, next question. This is from 2013 December. Which one of the following continents is at a greater risk of desertification? So the question is, which among the following continents is at the greatest risk, or the among this following has a greater risk of desertification? Now we know what is desertification. We have already covered it in the class. Desert like features. Now here also you can actually eliminate. So tell me which among the following continents are at a higher risk of desertification. Definitely you can get the answer. Maybe no need to hurry. You can think for 30 seconds and then try to answer it. Neetu is asking me, I have a doubt in question related to biosphere. Yes, all of them are included in man and biosphere program, but special recognition is given. Even though we have, you know, okay, I'll come to that. I think I did not explain it in the class. Okay, I'll just explain that. Neetu's question, and then we will answer this, okay? So, I'm just drawing it. Okay, now, Neetu's question is, I think we'll go to that question itself. Yeah, this was the question. Which one of the following biosphere reserves has UNESCO recognition? Now, UNESCO has recognized, I'm so sorry, okay. So, UNESCO has recognized a few biosphere reserves under the Man and Biosphere Program, MAB. Now, here the question is not about Man and Biosphere Program. Within the Man and Biosphere Program, UNESCO has selected four among them, giving them special recognition. So, the question is relating to that special recognition. Now, which are these four biosphere reserves which has a special recognition? I'll just explain. Okay. Okay. Now, four biosphere reserves has given, actually not biosphere reserves, four such biosphere, yeah, in, from the MAB has been given this UNESCO special recognition. So one is Greater Nicobar, another one is the Eastern Himalayan area, And another one is the biosphere reserves in the Western Ghats. So it includes the Nilgiri and all. So biosphere reserves from the Western Ghats, from the Eastern Himalayas, then from the Nicobar, and also one more is there, I forgot now. So basically four of them are given some special recognition. So this question is regarding that. Okay, Neetu, I hope it's clear for you now. All of them are included in MAB, man and biosphere, but even among that, UNESCO has given special recognition to four. Okay. Lipika, join the class late. It's okay, Lipika. It's okay. Like at least you join, no? That's okay. Okay. Neetu, I hope it's clear for you now. Now, our question now was regarding, which among the following continents are at a higher risk of desertification? Answer is D, C, D, A, Africa. Okay, let's see. Okay, Neetu has said it's clear. Okay. Answer is Africa. Africa is at a risk of desertification, greater risk of desertification. Okay. Which one of the following is not a matter of global concern in the removal of tropical forest? So, which one of the following is not a matter of global concern in the removal of tropical forest? Their ability to absorb the chemicals that contribute to depletion to ozone layer, their role in maintaining the oxygen and carbon balance on Earth. Now, their ability to regulate surface air temperatures, moisture content and reflectivity, their contribution to the biological diversity of the planet. This is a very simple question. Now here, whenever you get a not question, you have to note it down, because it can, in the examination center, you may get confused. Okay. Neetu is asking me, due to drought. Yes, due to drought, Africa is facing a threat of desertification. Now the question here is, actually the question is an indirect question. Here the question is only about what is the purpose or the functions of a tropical tropical forest. So we have discussed about tropical forest and their functions or their purpose also. So which among this are not a purpose? So question here is, if you remove the tropical forest, which will not be a impact? So indirectly the question is asking you about the functions and the purpose of a tropical forest. So first one is, just think, okay, whether the tropical forest has an ability to absorb the chemicals that contribute to depletion of ozone layer. Does it have? Think. Second one, does it play a major role in maintaining oxygen balance and carbon balance? Think about it. Then whether they regulate the surface and air temperature, moisture content and reflectivity? Think. And whether they contribute to the biological diversity of the planet. A. Surbhi has commented. Any other answers? Das has commented D. Any other? A, B. A, okay, B, A, okay. Let's see, Neetu, and what about others? Rani, Pavan Kumar, Lipika. So Vanita has commented B. Mm-hmm. These questions are all very easy. You can even use the elimination technique. I'll explain how. Let's see the answer. A. Why A? I gave you the clue that, see, your question is very direct. So you just have to see which is not a function. So is there any function for the tropical forest to absorb the chemicals that contribute to the ozone layer? So which are the chemicals that contribute to the depletion of ozone layer? It's mainly the CFCs. And we know that CFCs are released from air conditioners and refrigerators. So what is the purpose of a tropical forest? You can directly get the answer, but even though you don't get, how you can use the elimination technique in such type of questions, I'll just explain. So first, coming to option B, their role in maintaining the oxygen and carbon balance. Now, when we have discussed about the tropical forest, we have seen that tropical forests are where the rainfall is abundant, and therefore we have a evergreen tropical forest or deciduous tropical forest. We know that, at least we know that abundance of rainfall creates the tropical forest. So if there is an abundance of rainfall, there will be highly, you know, diverse plants and animals. Animals means organisms, we can say. And we have also seen that when we discussed about coral reefs, it is known as the tropical rainforest of the ocean. So we know tropical forest receives a large amount of rainfall. So the plant growth will be very high. Because of abundance of rainfall, the plant and the tree growth will be very high. And plants are responsible for conducting photosynthesis. So in conducting photosynthesis, what do? They absorb the carbon and they give out the oxygen. So therefore, definitely they play a major role in maintaining the oxygen and carbon balance. Second one, their ability to regulate the surface and air temperatures, moisture content and reflectivity. This is also because of abundance of plants and trees in the rainforest or tropical forest. Then their contribution to biological diversity. Tropical forest or tropical rainforest has degree of biodiversity because there are many number of plants, trees and organisms found in this type of forest. So even though you do not know the answer is A, you can simply eliminate B, C and D if you just know that tropical forest has abundance of rainfall, therefore the plant growth is very high. So this is how you can use the elimination technique if you do not know the answer. By eliminating the wrong choices, you can come at the right one if you do not know the answer directly. Okay, but that's okay, this is just a trial. When we make mistakes here, definitely we will go with the right answer in the real exam. Okay, yeah. The most comprehensive approach to address the problem of man-environment interaction. So the most comprehensive approach to address the problems of man-environment interaction is one of the following: natural resource conservation approach, urban industrial growth oriented approach, rural agricultural growth oriented approach, watershed development approach. This is also very simple. Here also you can use the elimination technique. So here the question is, which one is the most comprehensive approach in order to address the problems of man-environment interaction? In the first class or in the second class, I think it was in the first module, we discussed about the interdependence of human beings and the environment, and sometimes it creates a negative impact. So how we can go away, or how we can do away with the negative impact. So this is a very simple question. So what is the approach that we should adopt? Very easily you can eliminate two options from this, then you will come at two remaining options, and from that you can just put this word comprehensive. Okay, so here when we do the test series, it's not a revision as such. It's a revision definitely, but more than that, it is also a way how you can approach the questions in the exam. Gate Lectures website of test series is not working. I am not sure, Yusuf. I'll just check it with the team. Okay, so it'll be A. Okay, any other answers? Easily you can eliminate two. I'll just give you a clue. Okay, try to solve this problem by yourself. I want everyone to answer this. Easily, very, very easily you can eliminate two options from here. Then you will have two options left. Then from that, you have to just see which one is more comprehensive. You will get the answer. I need everyone to answer this. A, B, C, C, okay. Any more answers? D, D, okay. Can we check? D. Why D is the answer? I told you, you can simply eliminate two options. One is urban industrial growth. Urban industrial growth oriented, which means the focus is given on industrial growth. So definitely pollution and other externalities are there, and also an exploitation of resources. Rural agricultural growth. So even though it's agricultural, what happened in case of green revolution? We know, we have explained that example in the class also. The green revolution belt, which is Punjab Haryana belt, what happened? Due to higher orientation given for higher yield or agricultural productivity, the water was used, the groundwater got depleted, the use of chemical fertilizers. So all these resulted into environmental consequences. So you can easily eliminate both these options, B and C. Then natural resource conservation approach. So conservation, we do not need a conservation, but we need sustainability. Oh, I hope you remember this, we discussed in class. So more than conservation, what we need is sustainability. Sustainability of the resources. Then out of A and D, you can reach here, watershed development approach. Okay. Next, oh, I'm sorry. Next one, I did not mark the question differently. So, okay. The answer is given here. That's my mistake, because I did not make a different slide for the question. The major source of pollutant gas, carbon monoxide in urban area, it's transport sector. Okay. In a fuel cell driven vehicle, the energy is obtained from the combustion of. So fuel cell driven vehicle, the energy is obtained from the combustion of methane, hydrogen, LPG or CNG. Okay, asking me about watershed development. I'll just explain. Try to answer this, I'll explain. A, C, D. Okay, any other answers? We'll just check the answer. It's B, hydrogen. Okay. Okay. Now we'll see what is watershed development. Now, first of all, we need to understand what is a watershed. So first one, watershed. What is watershed? So, watershed means it's an area, it's a piece of land, it's an area or a region which is delimited, which means delimitation means categorized, or which is, delimitation. What do you say for delimitation? which is separated from a different region, okay, which is delimited. And this delimitation, a very good example is constituencies. You have electoral constituencies, so delimitation commission forms these constituencies. That is, one constituency is separated from the other. So likewise, a region is delimited or separated from the other region, and the basis for this delimitation is a common drainage outlet flowing of all water inside one place, which means that in this particular area there will be a river, there can be a pond, there can be lakes or different kind of water sources. So what happens here, the drainage, common drainage outlet of all flowing water is inside this place. That is, every water body in this watershed, you know, the ponds, the lakes, etc., has a same watershed. It, the drainage is the same. Now, a very good example I'll give you for watershed. A very good example of watershed is, you must have seen, if you live in the rural areas and all, your panchayat or your village and all, at the micro level, especially in the panchayat level, what they do is, especially in the rain fed areas, if your area receives a lot of rainfall and all, what they do is, they will create this rainwater harvesting plans and all. So this is an example of watershed management program. So watershed means nothing, but this is an approach for the conservation of water resources. So watershed, basically watershed means an area in which all the water resources, whether it is ponds or lakes or everything, they will have a common drainage so that the water is conserved. And watershed management program means that whatever water resources we have in a particular area, they are being conserved. So that is watershed management. Very good example is rainwater harvesting. Next is, which of the following cities has been worst affected by urban smog in the recent times? I think we have discussed about this also. So Paris, London, Los Angeles and Beijing. Okay, so which of the cities have been worst affected by the urban smog? So, it's a 2014 question. I thought of like stopping it in 2013, but we'll take up this question and then wind up, okay? C, Los Angeles. Any other answer? Which of the following cities has been worst affected by urban smog? A, we'll check the answer. It's Beijing. The question is, in the recent times, London and Los Angeles is very famous for its smog. We have discussed about London smog and Los Angeles smog, but recently Beijing is one city which has been very much affected by smog. It's due to high industrial activities in Beijing. I will also see whether there is an updation now. So this is 2014 question. I will also see, but I think it's Beijing only, because I just googled it and found out that Beijing is one of the most polluted cities now. Okay. I'll just check it and cross check it. Yeah. Rainwater harvest system in every house by panchayat. Okay. Sumati, which state do you belong to? I think you have told me, but I forgot. Is it Andhra Pradesh? I forgot. So with this, we will conclude today. Tomorrow we will take up the remaining 2014 questions. Okay. So please do revise and okay, Tamil Nadu. Okay, Sumati. So please do revise your lessons and we will do the remaining tomorrow. Tomorrow we will try to finish 2014 and 15. Okay, tomorrow is actually a very special day in Kerala. So maybe most of you must be knowing about Onam. So we have Onam tomorrow, but still I'll be taking the classes tomorrow 7:30. So everyone who is from Kerala, I wish you all a very, very happy Onam. And for others also, from our side, on behalf of all the students and the team from Kerala, I wish you all a very, very happy Onam. So Okay, so be happy. And tomorrow, anyway, I'll be taking class tomorrow. Tomorrow is Monday, and tomorrow I'll take class. But day after tomorrow, I'll be taking a break because my mother has a eye surgery day after tomorrow, Tuesday. So day after tomorrow, I'll not be taking the classes. Tomorrow we will meet, and day after tomorrow I will not. And I request all of your prayers also for my mother. And some questions have come up. Lipika, no, flash flood we did not. Why? Because there are few other topics also from the test series that we will be discussing towards the end. So we will do that towards the end. Okay. We have not discussed, Lipika, don't worry. Happy Onam Neetu, happy Onam Sumati, Puri, happy Onam. So wish you all a very, very, very happy Onam. So I'll see you tomorrow, and day after tomorrow I'll be taking a break. But I'll try to compensate that class by taking one extra hour or something. Don't worry about that. Okay. So take care. Bye bye. And do your revision very well. Exams are fast approaching. So yeah, do well. So take care. Bye bye. I'll see you. Hello friends, and welcome to Digimento. So I'm really sorry for the technical error what has happened. I'm really sorry for that. So yeah, okay. So there was some technical issue, that's why we were not able to start the class on time. Let's start. We were discussing the last 10 year question papers from the chapter 9 or unit 9, which we discussed, which we have already completed. So today we will be continuing with that. If you remember, we discussed 2010, 11, 12 and 13, 4 years. So now what we will be doing is we will be taking up 2014 today. Okay, so let's begin. But before that, if you have not yet subscribed to our channel, please do subscribe to our channel, and also press the bell icon for receiving the future notifications. And if you are preparing for GATE, NTA, UGC NET or PGT Computer Science, you can avail our online courses. And for that, you can visit our website or you can call to this number for getting more details about the same. Okay, so let's begin. So 2010, 11, 12, 13, we have finished so far. So now let's take up 2014. Okay, tell me if I'm not audible, or if there is any issues there, please let me know. Okay, so hi Rani, hi Gajalakshmi. If I'm not audible, let me know. Okay, I'll just check if there is any issue. So, am I audible now? So, if I'm audible, let me know. Okay, okay. So, we'll start from 2014. Very sorry for being late, and I know you have the next session at 9 o'clock. So, we will just quickly start, okay? And Rani, thank you so much, and happy Onam to you as well. We had a good day, but actually because of the situations, we did not celebrate and all, but the day was good. Like we made the food and everything. So otherwise, which we call as Onam Sadhya in Kerala. So we made Sadhya and all, mini Sadhya, but it was good. My daughter likes Sadhya, and especially we make this payasam. Which is kind of like, you know, sweet dessert. It's called kheer in North India. I think it's called kheer. So we made that also. So yeah, she likes that. So it was good. Now, yeah, I think this question we started or like we discussed yesterday. Which of the following cities has been worst affected by urban smog in the recent times? So I'm sure you can answer it, because yesterday we have discussed it's Beijing. Next question. The primary source of organic pollution in freshwater bodies. So this also is a direct question which we have discussed in our class. I don't know, maybe because I started late and because of the technical issues, there are very less number of participants today. Yakub is there, Rani is there, Gajalakshmi is there, and Das is there. So if others are attending, please let me know. So yeah. Okay, if others are also attending the classes, let me know. Please tell me a hi, hello in the comment section so that I'll be knowing about it. So let's start anyways and let's wait for others to join the session. Hi Neetu, and Evin has commented, actually he's my brother. So hi, I call him Chacha. So hi Chacha. Neetu, Lipika, Lab has joined. So good evening everyone, happy Onam. So let's start. The primary source of organic pollution in freshwater bodies. Runoff urban areas, runoff from agricultural farms, sewage effluents, industrial effluents. So which one is the major primary source or the major source of organic pollution in freshwater bodies? This is the question. And this is a direct question from our class only. So I hope you can answer this. Let me know your answers. Then we will discuss the right one. Okay. C, B, B, okay. Any other answers? B, B, B. Okay. The answer is C. Neetu has made it right. I'm so happy. Because this was one question that we discussed in the class. I told you, especially in the urban areas, sewage effluents is the primary source of organic pollution in the freshwater bodies. So, yeah. Next question. Lahar is a natural disaster involving eruption of large amount of material, strong winds, strong water waves, strong wind and water waves. So what is Lahar? So you have to answer us. I think this also we have discussed in the class. So there is no need of much confusion. Let me know the answer in your comment section. Then we will go to the right answer. A. Okay. C, D. Okay. So, C. Sumati has commented about the link problem. Actually, that was an issue from my side. Actually, what happened, for 7:30 only, the team created the link. Then later, what happened, when I started taking the classes, the PPT was not visible. So there was some problem with the software that I was using. So I had to contact the team. Then they had to resolve the issue. That's why it got late. Then they had to generate a different link and all that. So that issue was from my part today. I'm sorry. Basically, I am a person who doesn't have any knowledge about technology, or even I don't even use my laptop or this gadgets and all, but only for taking classes. I am like very much unfamiliar with all these. So if there is like a small issue also, I need some help from someone. I cannot resolve it myself. So that was the issue. So yes, so I think we'll see. So A is the answer, eruption of large amount of material. So Lahar, we discussed this already in the class. Next one, in order to avoid catastrophic consequences of climate change, there is general agreement among the countries of the world to limit the rise in average surface temperatures of Earth compared to that of pre-industrial times by. So this is actually a question from the Paris Climate Change Agreement. So here the general agreement, it talks about the Paris Climate Change Agreement. So in this Paris Climate Change Agreement, the member countries or the countries have agreed to bring down the temperatures. So what is the limit or agreement among the countries of the world to limit the rise in average surface temperatures of Earth compared to that pre-industrial times. So what is the temperature limit that the countries have agreed to bring down? So this is the question. So option 1.5 degree Celsius to 2 degree Celsius, 2 to 3.5, 0.5 to 1, 0.25 to 0.5. So this is a very direct question from the Paris Climate Change Agreement. JD has asked me, can you provide all my videos? Yes, all the videos are Himanshu sir has compiled all the videos and it's available. So I will ask sir to share with you the link in the Telegram channel so that you can access the Telegram channel, the link from the Telegram channel. So I'll do that. And Vikrant has asked me, how are you? I'm good, Vikrant, and I hope you are also doing good. Thank you, Vikrant. So Neetu has commented A. Let's see, let's wait for other answers also. Lab has asked me, can we find in a series all these video? Actually, what sir has done, sir has combined all the live sessions and he has made a single, not single, actually 3-4 videos of like 7 to 8 hours video. I think it's available on the channel. If not, I'll ask sir to share the link of that video with you in the Telegram. Okay. So different answers are coming, A, B. So which one is the answer? Tell me. I want everyone to answer. See. I already follow your channel, but there are, yes, basically I am a UPSC teacher. I take ecology, economics and Indian polity for UPSC exams. But Himanshu sir is my friend and ecology is one subject which I am really, really interested in. So I thought, okay, I will take the classes here also. For this examination, whatever videos are available on Digi Mento channel, I will ask sir to get the link for you. So I'll do that. Don't worry. And Atira has commented PPTs are not yet uploaded. I think it's already uploaded. There are 4 or 5 channels. Can you check all the channel? Because when I asked the team about it, they said they have uploaded all the PPTs. I'll just check it once again with the team. Okay. And hi Puviri. So yeah, let's check the answer. Answer is A. So under the Paris Agreement, the countries, they agreed to reduce the temperature. Now you know what is increase in surface temperatures. It is global warming. So it leads to global warming. So agreement was that 1.5 degree Celsius to 2 degree Celsius, the average temperature will be limited. So compared to that of the pre-industrial time, so that the global warming rate will come down. Okay, next one. The National Disaster Management Authority functions under the Union Ministry of. If you remember, we discussed about NDMA in detail, National Disaster Management Authority. So under which Union Ministry does the NDMA works? Environment, Water Resources, Home Affairs or Defense? A, defense. C, okay, any other answers? Disaster Management Authority. A, C, A, okay, the answer is A. It works under the Union Ministry of Environment, MOEFCC, Union Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. So A is the answer. Next one. This is a match the following question, and yesterday I already told you that if you do not know all the answers in match the following, at least if you know one or two answers, you will arrive at the right answer, right option. So just try. Flood. We have 4 natural disasters here on list 1. So we have flood, drought, earthquake and volcano. In the list 2, we have the reasons for that. So what is the reason for the occurrence of those natural disasters? It's very simple. If you know at least one, I think 1 or 2 you can answer. So flood is, which one is related to flood, which one is related to drought, which one is related to earthquake and which one is related to volcano. So here everyone has gone for A. So let's check the answer. A is the right answer. Why? Because flood occurs because of excess rain and uneven distribution of water. So flood is caused due to excess rainfall and uneven distribution of water. Next is drought. Drought is caused due to lack of rainfall of sufficient duration. Third one is earthquake. Now earthquake is related to tremors produced by the passage of vibratory waves through the rock of the earth. And volcano, it's a vent through which molten substances come out. So these are the four right choices. Next question, which one of the following greenhouse gases has the shortest residence time in the atmosphere? So which one? All of these are greenhouse gases. So all these are greenhouse gases, and among this, which gas has the shortest residence time? That is, which one among these gases stays in the atmosphere for the shortest time? So options are chlorofluorocarbon, carbon dioxide, methane and nitrous oxide. So which is the right one? So which one stays in the atmosphere for the very short time? C, D, any other answers? A, C, D. B, C, C. Okay. Let's see. Any other answers? Okay. Answer is C. Methane stays in the atmosphere for the shortest time. Okay. Next question, consider the following statements and select the correct answer. So here four statements are given. So you have to see which among these statements are correct. Rajasthan receives the highest solar radiation in the country. So Rajasthan, whether Rajasthan receives the highest solar radiation. India has the fifth largest installed wind power in the world. The maximum and amount of wind power is contributed by Tamil Nadu. And the primary source of uranium in India is Jharsuguda. So these are the four options. So here also you can use the elimination technique. If you know maybe at least one or two options right, or at least if you know that one option is wrong, you can eliminate. Think carefully, you will definitely get the answer by elimination technique. B, 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 okay, let's see. B. Time of methane stage, I'll explain. Okay, B, C, B. Okay, let's see the answer. Answer is D, 1 and 4. So, okay, here how you can use the elimination technique. Rajasthan receives the highest solar radiation in the country. So, this is quite obvious, okay. So, first option is quite obvious. So, you marked it right. Now, India has the fifth largest installed wind power in the world. So, when we discussed about wind power, I think we discussed about how India... Okay, Lipika has commented it right. So, when we discussed about wind power and wind energy and all, I think we have discussed about India's unexplored potential. So, I'll just tell you... okay, so yeah, now we have a lot of, you know, wind power, but that is mostly unutilized. So we have a very good amount of wind energy potential, but mostly unutilized. But still, India has the fifth largest. So here question is fifth largest. Now, even though I think I have explained this to you when I taught you about the wind energy, even though we have a lot of unexplored or unutilized wind energy, still we have a very, very large installed capacity in wind energy, and now India is fourth largest. So potential is still there, but even though we have a lot of unutilized potential, still we are fourth. I think it's after US, China and some Germany or France or something like that. I don't really remember, but after US, China and Germany, I guess. So India is the fourth largest. So this one. Next, the maximum amount of wind power, it is contributed by Tamil Nadu. So this is a wrong answer. Maximum is contributed by Maharashtra, again Rajasthan, then Karnataka, etc. So these are the top states. And fourth one, even I did not know about it, but I told you elimination technique, because if you know that 3 is wrong, definitely you can eliminate B and C. Again, if you know that, then the remaining choices are 1 and 4 and 1 and 2. So among, anyway, 1 is for sure. So you have to choose between second statement and fourth statement. So second statement, if you knew that India has a lot of potential and also we are also one among the top producers of wind energy, then definitely you could have made it right. Even the fourth option was unfamiliar for me. So if I was writing the exam, definitely I would have used this elimination technique only. Now which country is number one? Number one is China. Wind energy, China is number one. Next one, in terms of total CO2 emissions from a country, identify the correct sequence. So US, China, India and Russia are the four options. So you have to identify which country emits the largest CO2, carbon dioxide, among these given options. B. Okay, let's check. B is the correct one. China, US, India and Russia. So this is the correct sequence. Okay, largest emitter is China. Next one, this is again match the following. So here also, if you know at least one, you can answer. World Health Day, World Population Day, World Ozone Day and World AIDS Day. So maybe at least one you may be knowing. So if you know that, you can answer it. B. Okay, World AIDS Day is 1st of December. Most of you might be knowing that. So if that is the right one, then see which option has 2 as D. So you can go for it. B. Okay. World Ozone Day is your birthday. So it's 16th of September. Okay. Even I remember that, because 16th of September is my best friend's birthday. So even I remember that. Yes, B. Okay, I think most of you have gone for B, and B is the right answer. Okay. Next one. Which of the anthropogenic activity accounts for more than 2/3 of global water consumption? So which one, which of the anthropogenic activity accounts for more than 2/3 of global water consumption? So yes, 15th of September is Engineers Day. Okay. So this is a question that we have discussed in the class. So I'm sure you will be able to answer it. Okay, give me your answers in the comment section. एग्रीकल्चर ए ओके ए. आई थिंक नो कन्फ्यूजन, ए इज द आंसर. दिस इज वन स्टेटमेंट विच वी हैव डिस्कस इन द क्लास, सो आई वॉज श्योर दैट यू विल मेक इट राइट. ओके ए. ओके, शैल वी गो टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. वन ऑफ द एंथ्रोपोजेनिक सोर्सेस ऑफ गेशियस पोल्यूटेंट्स क्लोरो फ्लूरो कार्बन्स इन द एयर इज. वन ऑफ द एंथ्रोपोजेनिक सोर्सेस ऑफ क्लोरो फ्लूरो कार्बन्स, सीमेंट इंडस्ट्री, फर्टिलाइजर इंडस्ट्री, फॉर्म इंडस्ट्री, पेस्टिसाइड इंडस्ट्री. इफ द क्वेश्चन वॉज लाइक विच वन, लाइक वॉट आर द सोर्सेस ऑफ गेशियस एंड द ऑप्शन, इफ यू हैड द ऑप्शन लाइक यू नो air conditioners and refrigerators, I'm sure you will make it right. But here you have to, this question is a little tricky. You have to apply your brains and find out the right one. So which of the anthropogenic sources, so cement, fertilizer, form, pesticide. C, B. Okay. Any other answers? C. Okay. Answer is C, foam industry. Okay. I think this also we have discussed in class about the foam industry. The cyclone Hudhud hit the coast of which state? Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, Kerala, Gujarat. Hudhud. We discussed about cyclones and the recent ones. I don't know whether I had included Hudhud or not. Let's still try to answer it. This was a question asked in 2014 and I think we discussed only from 2015 or something. So not sure, but still try to answer. Now this question will not come because only they will ask the recent ones. So this question will not come anyways. They will only ask you the recent ones and we have discussed the recent ones in the class. So Kerala, A, Andhra Pradesh, okay. Let's check. A. Answer is A, Andhra Pradesh. Now, here also, if you do not, since NET exam do not have this negative grades, so you can still take a chance. So that's why I'm giving you this trick, because sometimes if these questions, you know, seems to be like you do not know, you have no clue, then still you can apply some logic. So here in this question, one logic that you can apply is, in the class we said that it is mostly the eastern coast compared to the western coast, which where the cyclones are more prone and severe. So it is the eastern coast which is more prone to cyclones. And now what is the reason? The reason is that the Bay of Bengal, which is in the eastern coast, the Bay of Bengal has more cyclonic activities as compared to the Arabian Sea. So Arabian Sea has lesser cyclonic activities compared to the Bay of Bengal. And I told you this also in the class that most of the times every year there is at least one cyclone happening in Odisha or West Bengal. So why? Because they are in the eastern coast. So Andhra Pradesh also falls in the same belt. So eastern coast, Odisha, Andhra Pradesh, West Bengal. So they are in the same belt, eastern coast. So mostly it is the eastern coast. And I also told you in the western coast, it's very rare. Even though cyclones hit the western coast like Kerala, Gujarat and all, mostly Kerala and all, but it's very rare. So using that, if you do not have any clue, you can use that technique to eliminate. So Karnataka, Kerala, Gujarat and all, you can simply eliminate using that clue. So Andhra Pradesh, West Bengal and Odisha, these are three states which are very severely prone to cyclones. So if you do not know the right answer, you can just apply this technique, okay? Only if you do not know. But if you directly know that it belongs to the state, then you can answer. Otherwise, if you are clueless about it, you can apply this type of logic and then just do the answers, because there is no negative marking anyways. Even if you go wrong, it's better you can take a chance than not to apply any or like, you know, attempt the question. Okay. Next one, which of the following is not a renewable natural resource? We have discussed about the differences between renewable and non-renewable natural resources. So renewable and non-renewable is there. Renewable means which can be renewed or replenished easily, and there are also non-renewable. So which of the following is not a renewable? So here the question is, which among the following is non-renewable? And I think yesterday in 2013 question also, question paper also, we have discussed the same question, which means that the questions will come repeatedly. So I think we have already discussed it, and the answer is D, salt is the answer. Which the factors which are most important in determining the impact of, this is 2015 June question paper. So the factors which are most important in determining the impact of anthropogenic activities on environment. So here the question is, you have to tell me the factors which are most important in determining the impact of anthropogenic activities. This question also I think we have discussed earlier. So tell me which one. A, C, C, let's see. C is the answer. This is a question that we have already discussed. I don't think there is a need for more explanation. Okay. Population, affluence per person, and the technology used for exploiting the resources. Now, India's contribution to total global carbon dioxide emissions is about. Now, this is not an exact figure now, because this question was asked in 2015. So definitely there are some changes, but still we will get some, you know, average figures. So yeah, we'll just discuss it. So B, no idea. Okay. Is around 6%, but as I told you, not very important, because this was asked in 2015. So such type of very statistical questions, it's not very important, because maybe 5 years back or even 2 years back, it was entirely different. In which of the countries per capita use of water is maximum? So here per capita, not about the overall use of water, but the question is about in which of the countries per capita use of water is maximum. US, India, European Union, China. So you have four options. And among this four options, I'll also give you a clue. China and India, both these countries are most populous countries. So population in these countries are very high. Now, US and European Union, these are the most developed countries or most developed economies. So this is the clue. Now question is about per capita use of water. So I hope you can find out the answer. Let's check. Okay. Answer is European Union. Now, why not India and China? Even though the water use in general is very high in India and China, the population is very high. So if when we divide the total use of water divided by population, which will give us per capita use, then it comes down because of the high population. So European Union. Now, even here also you could have used this elimination technique, because I have given you this clue that India and China are the most populous countries. So definitely when we divide the total use divided by population, so total use of water divided by population is the per capita use of water. Now what happens when the denominator increases? Definitely the answer will come down. So In that way, you can eliminate India and China. Now, the remaining two options were US and European Union. Now, the question was not about one particular country from Europe, but it was about European Union, which means there are lot number of countries in the European Union. So, definitely the use will be high in European Union. So, here also you could have definitely applied this elimination technique if you do not know the answer. If you directly know the answer, it was okay. But if you do not know, US and European Union. European Union is a culmination of so many countries. Now, Britain has exited from European Union recently. But the question was not about Britain or UK or France or Germany, but this was about European Union, which is a union of many European countries. Definitely the use would have been very high because of the level of development. So in US also the development is very high, but there are more countries in European Union. So, okay. Next one, two earthquakes A and B happen to be of magnitude 5 and 6 respectively on Richter scale. The ratio of the energy released is EB divided by EA. So EB is the energy of B divided by energy of A. So the ratio will be approximately. So how much will be the approximate ratio? So this is the question. Any guess? D. Okay. Don't know. B. Answer is D. So can you tell me, Atra, how did you get D? Energy release is directly proportional to magnitude. Yes. So can someone tell me? Even I am not able to explain this question. I'm really sorry. I'm very weak in math. So the logic is that energy released is directly proportional to the magnitude. So this question, I'm really sorry. The mathematical part, I'm not able to explain. Six by five. Yes, 6 by 5. But answer will be like 1.6 divided. No, 6 by 5 or 5 by 6. No, 6 by 5. Yes, 6 by 5, and answer will be 1.2. So how this ratio has come? I am not sure about it. Yes. Okay, Adira said. Okay, Neetu, I'll do one thing. I'll just check it today. I'll see how this this explanation I'll take, and I'll tell you next day. No, next day or like whenever we discuss all the questions that we were keeping for the final day, when we will explain it. Okay, this question I have noted down. Okay, let's leave this question here, but we will explain it. Okay. In the recently launched air quality index in India, which of the following pollutants is not included? So it was recently launched in 2015, but now it's been like 5 years, but the same pollutants are included in that. No change. So chlorofluorocarbons, carbon monoxide, fine particulate matter, ozone. So which one is not included in the air quality index? This also you can definitely answer through elimination, because if you have attended the classes, you can definitely eliminate one option from this, and that is the right one. Can someone tell me the answer for this? CFC. Okay. Anybody else? Any other answers? A C, okay. That's it, answer. It's A, because we know that chlorofluorocarbons is directly related to ozone layer. So this is not included in air quality index. It's related to ozone layer. And the air quality index, it was basically launched in order to measure the quality of air in a particular area. So the quality of air, especially in cities like Delhi, so ozone is somewhere in the stratosphere. So chlorofluorocarbons is related to ozone layer depletion. So we can eliminate this, and definitely this is the right answer. So yeah. Next one, which of the following combinations represent renewable natural resource? So here the question is, which among the following is a combination of renewable natural resources? Oil, forest and tides, fertile soil, fresh water and natural gas, clean air, phosphates and biological diversity, fishes, fertile soil and fresh water. So which one is a combination of renewable natural resource? Here also you can use this elimination technique. Why? Because in every option, in every wrong option, there's one non-renewable natural resource. So you can definitely use the elimination technique here also. So JD has given an answer explanation. By the scale, magnitude 6 earthquake would result in 10 times of the level of shaking as magnitude 5 earthquake and released energy 33 times. Okay, I think that is the right explanation because it seems to be logical. Thank you, JD, for this. So here, by the scale, magnitude 6 earthquake will result in 10 times of the level of shaking as compared to magnitude 5. And released energy 33 times. So yeah. Hi Gaurav. Gaurav, this is not computer science class. This is paper one class. I started it late, that's why. I'll end the session in 5 minutes or so. I know you have the next session. I started it very late today, so I'll end it soon in 5 minutes. So let's see the answer. Answer is D. Why? I'll just tell you why, how you can eliminate. So in the first option, in the option A, there is oil, which is definitely a non-renewable resource. Again, natural gas is a non-renewable resource. Here, phosphates, it's a non-renewable resource. Now here, fishes are renewable. Fertile soil and fresh water, all these are renewable sources of energy. Okay, JD, no problem. I think your answer is right and your logic is also correct. Thank you so much. Yeah, so I hope this is understood. Next one, inside rural homes, the source of or sources of nitrogen oxide pollution. We have discussed this also about the indoor air pollution. So, which are the sources of nitrogen oxide pollution? Sources of nitrogen oxide pollution inside the rural homes. Unvented gas stoves, wood stoves, kerosene heaters. Das is asking me how fishes. Fishes are renewable. If suppose a very good example I'll give you. I think it was in Australia. So there was a natural waters and the fishes were extinct there because of high level of pollution. And there was a report during the COVID-19 lockdown that the fishes started coming back. So whenever there is a condition which is suitable for living, this fishes will definitely regenerate. So that is why fishes are renewable. JD's explanation. So yeah, JD will explain it again and I'll try to explain too. Okay, here answer is D, 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 D. Okay, let's see. D is the answer. Unvented gas stoves, wood stoves and kerosene heaters, they are the major sources of indoor air pollution in the houses. Okay. Next one, which of the following pollutants can cause cancer in human beings? So, which of the following can cause cancer in the human beings? Which is cancerous? Carcinous. Okay. pesticides, mercury, lead, ozone. So I think all of them can cause cancer, but the question is about which one is more dangerous, maybe, because everything can cause cancer, but even for most of these, high quantities will cause cancer. Ozone can cause, sometimes we have discussed about skin cancer. Then again, lead, mercury, pesticides, if consumed in large amounts, everything can cause cancer, but which one would be the most appropriate answer? C, A, okay, pesticides, and C, lead, okay. Pesticides. Okay. Next one. This is an assertion reasoning question. People pollution control measures do not necessarily help in checking environmental degradation. Reason: the relationship between people, less population growth and environmental degradation is rather complex. So this is the assertion. Assertion is that people pollution control measures do not necessarily help in checking environmental. I think this also we have discussed this question also. So population control measures do not necessarily help in checking environmental degradation. So if you agree with that, you have to find the reason whether it is the relationship between population growth and environmental degradation is rather complex. So you have to find that. So what's your answer? B. Can we check? A. This is already discussed in the class, so we'll check. A is the answer. People pollution control, population control measures do not necessarily help in checking environmental degradation. Why? Because even though population control measures are adopted, it necessarily will not help in checking the degradation of environment. And reason is that the relationship between population growth and environmental degradation is very, very complex. Okay. So we have a few more questions in 2015. Sorry, I'm showing you the answers also. I think we will continue tomorrow. Okay. So we will wind up for today because you have the next session coming up. That's why we are winding up here. Not tomorrow. Tomorrow you will not have classes. You will not have my live class tomorrow. I am taking a break tomorrow. I think I told you yesterday that my mother has a very minor surgery. It is. She has an eye surgery tomorrow. So I'll be staying with her in the hospital tomorrow. So I may not be able to take the classes tomorrow. So I'm taking a break for tomorrow. We will continue from day after tomorrow. And please do remember my mother in all your prayers. I hope everything goes well. Even though it's a minor surgery, I hope everything goes well. So yeah, I'll meet you again day after tomorrow. Keep studying. Tomorrow's class I'll definitely compensate. I'll take an extra class for that. Okay. Yes, Lapshi is fine. She's fine now, but she has a small problem. She had a BP issue, blood pressure issue, and some of her blood vessels are blocked in the eyes, and there is a blood clotting. So doctor has to remove it through a surgery. So this blood clots from the eyes will be removed. So it's a minor surgery, but still she's a little scared about it because it's the first time she's undergoing a surgery in her life. So she's a little bit scared of it. So I'll be there for her tomorrow the whole day. So I may not be able to take class. So I told Himanshu sir, tomorrow I am leaving the session. I'm skipping. Day after tomorrow we will meet. Thank you so much for all your prayers and wishes. Thank you so much. Lab has commented. Preeti. Thank you, Preeti. Thank you, Lab. Thank you, Lipika. Thank you, Adra. Thank you, Firdos. Thank you, Das. And thank you, Rani. Thank you, everyone. Thank you. Poovidi, thank you, JD. So yeah, JD, the PPTs are available on Telegram channel. I'll just tell the team once again, if they have not uploaded them, I'll ask them to upload them on Telegram. So thank you so much everyone for your wishes, good wishes. I'll see you day after tomorrow. Hope to see you on day after tomorrow. Okay, until then, take care and study well. Do your revisions really well. And paper 2, I am not the right person to tell you how to do the revision and all, because I do not know anything about your paper 2. So, in your own ways and means, you do your preparations for paper 2 very well. And I hope to see you day after tomorrow. Take care, everyone. Okay, bye bye, and wish you all a very, very happy Onam once again. See you. Bye. Hello friends, and welcome to DigiMento. So let's start today's classes. Today we will be continuing with the questions that we were taking up yesterday. That means yesterday we were taking up certain model questions. So today we will complete, we'll try to complete those questions. Yesterday already we started with a few questions, and today we will be continuing with that. So if you have joined with me for the class, please do let me know. Send me a hi or hello so that I'll be able to know that you have joined the class. Hi Paramesh, good evening. So others, we will wait for like 5-6 people to join the classes so that we will be able to do this test paper. So if you have joined the class, please do send me a hi, hello. And this is our channel, and if you have not yet subscribed to our channel, please do subscribe to the channel and also press the bell icon and share this video with your friends as well. If you are preparing for GATE, NTA, UGC, NET or PGT Computer Science, you can avail the online courses from us. You can visit our website www.digimento.com or you can call to this number for getting more details. So if any others have also joined the classes, please let me know. Okay. Okay, I was not receiving the comments. I'm sorry, I just got it now. Hi Puvi, hi Yuvraj, hi Hari, hi Atira, hi Avnash, hi Pooja, hi Alagammai, hi Kiran, hi Lipika, and hi Ampika, hi Vinita. Hello everyone. So I think we will start now. Enough of you, I mean enough, the quorum has now been completed, so we will start. So we will be continuing from where we stopped yesterday. Okay, oh sorry. Okay, so this was the last question I think we discussed yesterday. So hello Atar, hi Ankit. So we will start with the next question. So read the question carefully from your side also, and then we will go to the solution. Okay. Which of the following indoor plant helps improve the indoor air quality? We have discussed about indoor air pollution. So which of the following indoor plants? So this question is about those indoor plants which will help in improving the air quality. Lipika is asking me, yesterday class was held. Yesterday we conducted this test. Some questions we discussed, and we will be continuing these questions today. Hi Neetu. So yeah, try to answer this question. Which of the following indoor plant helps to improve the air quality? Hi Vinayagam. So options are Arika palm, lady palm, dragon tree, or all of them. So tell me your answer, and then we will see. At least like I'll wait for 5-6 people to respond to this question, and then we will go to the answer. And one more thing is that all these questions I have made, this is like very much similar to the way questions are asked in your examination, your final examination. So please try to attempt them like very seriously, so that you will have a experience also in answering these questions in the paper 1. Okay, so B, C, D, D, A, C, D. Okay, so I think majority of you have gone for D. So yeah, we will see the answers. The answer is D. That means all of them. All of them means Arika palm, lady palm, dragon tree. So all these plants. So let's see the solution. A study conducted by NASA confirms that common houseplants are the natural air purifiers. So common house plants, they are natural air purifiers. That means they will purify the pollutants. Pollutants from the air, thus making it more better for breathing. These include aloe vera, areca palm, lady palm, dragon tree, bamboo, etc. So these are some of the indoor plants which help in improving the air quality indoors. So you can also try planting these small plants in your house premises also. Okay, I have basically this small bamboo which is called the lucky bamboo, and also I have aloe vera. So because we stay in a flat, we cannot plant so much trees, but still I have these plants inside my house. So you can also just try. Okay, now next question. Inside rural homes, the sources or the source of nitrogen oxide pollution may be. So here the question is, two things are important here. Now first part of the question, inside rural homes. Okay, so first part, that is inside rural homes, this gives us a clue that the question is about the indoor air pollution. Now even within indoor air pollution, the question is very specific to rural areas. So within indoor, so the question here is very specific. Within air pollution or indoor air pollution, it is specific in rural areas, the source or the sources of nitrogen oxide pollution. So nitrogen oxide pollution, unvented gas stoves, wood stoves and kerosene heaters. So which one can be, or which among the following can be the sources of nitrogen oxide pollution? D, B, D, D, okay. B, okay. A, B, D, C, okay. Here also I think majority has gone for D. So let's check the answer. The answer is D. In rural areas, the main sources of oxide pollution, nitrogen oxide pollution, it can be unvented gas stoves, wood stoves and kerosene heaters. Okay. So we have discussed about indoor air pollution, and in rural areas also we have discussed. So these are the major sources. Now let's come to the next question. Which of the following is the largest source of water pollution in major rivers of India? So here also the question is very specific. So the question is specific to major rivers. So among the major rivers of India, which of the following is the largest source of water pollution? So options are untreated sewage, agriculture runoff, unregulated small scale industries, religious practices. A, C, Q, Q, A, okay, A, B, okay. Now the question is very specific. Okay, now I'll wait for 2-3 people also to comment. A, A, B, B, A, D, okay. That's okay, Rosalind, that's okay. C, 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 okay. Now let's see what is the answer. The answer is A. Untreated sewage is the largest source of water pollution in major rivers of India. It also poses a lot of diseases. So now we will come to the question again. So here I will tell you how you can eliminate the options. So sometimes these options, they are very close to each other and you may get confused. But there is a solution. I'm really sorry. Okay, so there is a solution. You can eliminate. Now how? Let's start from D. So religious practices. Now we know that religious practices cannot be the largest source of water pollution. Sometimes if you connect it with Ganga and all, you may think, but still religious practices is not the largest anyway. So we can eliminate this option. Unregulated small scale industries. Now when I told you about the river valleys and the river banks, if you remember when we discussed about Ganga, river Ganga, we discussed about the river banks. So what did we say? The earlier civilizations were held or they were in the river banks, and river banks are also urban centers. Why? Because of high or huge human settlements, they are also urban centers. Why? Earlier people started cultivation in the river banks or river valleys because of the alluvial soil, which is the most fertile soil available. So agriculture was started there. Then after agriculture, when the industries came up, these industries and even the urban settlements started in the river banks because of the availability of resources like water, transportation, etc. So unregulated small scale industries. So small scale industries are mostly restricted to the interiors, not to the near the rivers. So small scale industries are mostly restricted to interiors. So we can eliminate that option also. If it was large industries, then there could have been like a confusion, but since this is a small scale industry given here, there is no need to confuse, because small scale industries, they must be mostly situated inside or in the interiors. Next is agriculture runoff. Agricultural runoff can be there, but there are two factors. One is rapid level of urbanization has diverted agricultural activities to the interiors. Second thing is that the amount or the quantity of agricultural pollutants from agricultural runoff is also less. So the option that is left out is untreated sewage, and this is one of the major sources of water pollution in major rivers of India. And apart from this, if the third option, that is C option, if it was unregulated large scale industries, then this could have also been a large source of water pollution. Okay. Okay. Now let's see the next question. Natural vegetation of an area needs to be preserved for the future, and this is mainly for the purpose of. Now read this question very, very carefully. Everybody can answer this question. Very simple question, but if you do not read the question carefully, you will not get the answer. Question is natural vegetation. So natural vegetation of an area, it needs to be preserved for the future for many purposes. So there are many purposes in preserving the natural vegetation, but the most important purpose, what is the most important purpose of preserving the natural vegetation for the future? First one is to provide habitat for the birds. Second one, to prevent soil erosion. Third one, for the study by scientists. And fourth one, providing material for breeding new species. Now here you will see that all the four options, all these four options are the need or the reason why we should preserve the natural vegetation for the future. But here the question is about which has to be given, or which is the most important purpose for which the natural vegetation is to be preserved for the future. So I'll give you some time, please think about it and then answer. Here understand, four of them are the needs, most important. What is the most important purpose? D, okay. D, 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 okay. Many, many answers are coming. D, okay. B, D, most of you D, okay. B, sometimes B and most of you D, okay. Let's see what is the right answer. D is the right answer. Natural vegetation of an area, it needs to be preserved for the future, The most important purpose is to provide material for breeding new species and to maintain the ecosystem cycle. To maintain the biodiversity, to maintain the ecosystem cycle, and also to provide material for breeding the new species. Here, thing is that all the options will match, but here the question is the most important function, mainly the most important function. Okay. Now, next one. It's a factual question. I added this question because I have seen even factual questions in your question paper. That's why I added this question. The term ecosystem was coined by, very simple, I think it's a direct question. B, A, okay. Okay, A. Okay, most of you have gone for A. So answer is A. Arthur Translay coined the term ecosystem to recognize the integration of the biotic community and its physical environment as a fundamental unit of ecology within a hierarchy of physical systems that span the range from atom to universe. Okay. Next question, which of the following are considered as producers in the food chain? So we have discussed about the food chain, if you remember. So which among these are the producers in a food chain? Carnivores, autotrophic plants, it's not pans, I'm sorry, it's plants. Herbivores, decomposers, so it's plants, okay. Carnivores, autotrophic plants, herbivores or decomposers. Which one is the producer in a food chain? B. Decomposers. B. C. Okay. Producers. Okay. Food chain starts with the producers. Primary consumer. Secondary consumer. Tertiary consumer. Okay. B, C, B, 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 okay. Any more answers? B, okay. Let's see. It's an obvious answer. It's B. Autotrophic plants are the origin of the food chain as they produce food for the herbivores. So food chain starts with the producers, which are the plants, green plants. Through photosynthesis, they prepare their own food and they are the producers. So they are capable of producing their own food. So autotrophic plants, so they are the producers. Then we have the primary consumers, who is the herbivores, which consume these plants. So they are the primary consumers. Then we have the carnivores, who are the secondary consumers, and the higher level of consumers and the predators. Okay. So this is the food chain. Now, next question, which of the following are the primary air pollutants? Now, if you remember, we discussed in the class about primary air pollutants and secondary air pollutants. So, which among the following are primary air pollutants? Suspended particulate matter, ozone, sulfur trioxide, smog, lead, methane. So, which among the following are primary air pollutants? We have discussed in detail about primary and secondary air pollutants. Now, recollect your memory and try to answer this question. Which among the following are primary air pollutants? A, C, B, okay. C, C, B, C, C, C. C, okay. I think we will see the answer now. Option is B. So primary air pollutants enter the atmosphere directly from the source. This is the definition of primary air pollutant. So those pollutants or those air pollutants which enter the atmosphere directly from the source is called the primary air pollutants. So suspended particulate matter, lead, methane, secondary, and these are all examples. Now secondary air pollutants are formed as a result of some chemical reactions, which includes ozone, sulfur trioxide, smog, etc. So B is the correct answer. So we will see B, option B, that is 1, 5 and 6. Now 1 is SPM, suspended particulate matter, 5 is lead, PB, and we have the methane. Okay, these are the primary air pollutants. Now the next question, which of the following is not a waterborne disease? Very, very simple question. So here, whenever you see a not, please mark it. Okay, so which of the following is not a waterborne disease carried by water? So options are typhoid, hepatitis, cholera, and dengue. So this question is very direct. Dengue, okay. Anybody else? Any other answers? B, D, okay. B, D, okay. So I think we will see the answer now. The confusion is between B and D only, but the right answer is D. I'll explain why and then we will come to the solution. Now, why you have a confusion between B and D? Even I got confused between B and D. The reason is that hepatitis, we commonly refer to hepatitis category B. So hepatitis B, it is a sexually transmitted disease, STD. So we think that since hepatitis B is a sexually transmitted disease, it cannot be waterborne. But here, see, they have not specifically said that it is hepatitis B. It is generally said hepatitis. So hepatitis can be of different forms, of which sometimes it can be carried by water as well. So that is why you have this confusion. Some people commented B. Even I also got confused in the first instance. But when we see dengue as an option, this is a very sure option because it is carried by mosquitoes. So dengue is not a waterborne disease. Dengue fever, it's a mosquito-borne tropical disease caused by the dengue virus. So I hope now this confusion is clear. So when I saw the option D, I was very clear. Why? Because it is definitely, dengue is definitely not a waterborne disease. It is carried by the mosquito. The vector is a mosquito. Okay. Next one, the dominant source of pollution due to oxides of nitrogen in urban areas. Now, here also the question is very specific about urban areas. So, the dominant, here dominant means the most important or the important source of pollution of oxides of nitrogen in urban area. So in urban area, what is the most important source of nitrogen oxides pollution? Options are road transport, commercial sector, energy use in industry and power plants. A, road transportation. Okay. A, okay. Okay, let's see. Anybody else? Any other option? A, okay. Okay, I think we will see the answer now. C also has come. So answer is A. The dominant source of pollution due to oxides of nitrogen in urban areas is road transportation. So in urban areas, road transportation is the most important source of pollution of oxides of nitrogen. Next question. Which of the anthropogenic activity accounts for more than two-thirds of global water consumption? So this is a very important fact also, and this we have already discussed in class also. So let's see, which of the following anthropogenic activity? Anthropogenic activity means human activity. So which of this human activity accounts for more than 2/3 of global water consumption. So 2/3 of water consumption, agriculture, hydropower generation, industry, domestic and municipal usage. So question, okay, answers A, agriculture, A, D, okay. So this is a very important fact also. Now any other answers? A. Most of you have gone for A, and I will also go for A. Worldwide agriculture accounts for more than 67% of water consumption, compared to 23% consumption by industry and 10% by the domestic use. So agriculture consumes about 2/3 of the global water resources, and this is a very important fact. Why? Because this has led to groundwater depletion in many places, especially when we talk about India. In major belts of agricultural production like Punjab, Haryana belt, Uttar Pradesh, etc., Maharashtra also, Maharashtra, Karnataka, etc., in these places the groundwater crisis is very severe. And there was also a recent report released by Niti Aayog, the policy think tank of the government of India. So Niti Aayog has also said that there is a huge groundwater crisis. And do you remember we discussed about the water table, the lowering of water table also? If you remember, we discussed this in the class about the lowering of water table because of the excessive use of water resources, especially for agriculture. So yes, so the answer is A, agriculture. Which of the following pollutants is major cause of respiratory diseases? Now when we discussed about the pollutants, we said that most of the pollutants, especially those air pollutants, are responsible for causing respiratory diseases. Now the question is, which of the following pollutants is the major cause of respiratory disease? Suspended fine particles, nitrogen oxides, carbon monoxide, volatile organic compounds. Now here all these are responsible for respiratory diseases, but the question is most important or the major cause by which of the following pollutants. Now you can I'll give you a clue regarding this question. You can eliminate the wrong options, or directly you can come to the most important one. How? I'll just give you a clue, okay. As the size of the pollutant reduces, it is very easy for the pollutants to enter into the lungs. So this is the clue for you. So as the size of the pollutants decreases, as the size of pollutants decreases, it's very easy for the pollutants to enter the lungs of the human body. Now you tell me the answer. C, okay, suspended fine particles. Any other answers? CA, okay. I think we will see the answer now. Answer is A, suspended fine particle is the major cause of respiratory diseases. Now I'll tell you, if you have any confusion regarding C, I think most of you or many of you have gone for the option C. Now carbon monoxide is also very dangerous, but it is the most toxic. So it is not the pollutant which is the major cause of respiratory disease. Of course it causes respiratory diseases, but the suspended fine particles, they are the major reason, because it can easily enter the lungs because of its fine nature. So SPM is found in 2.5 and 10. Okay. So they are very fine, so that they can easily enter the lungs of the human beings. Whereas carbon monoxide, it is highly toxic. That means the poison level or the level of chemicals in the carbon monoxide is very high. That small amount of carbon monoxide intake can also be dangerous for human life. I hope you got it now. Next question. Photochemical smog is caused by the reaction of which of the following compounds? We have discussed about photochemical smog and classic smog and the differences between both of them. Now you can easily answer this. Photochemical smog, it is caused by reaction of which of the following compounds? First option, nitrogen oxides and volatile organic compound, sulfur dioxide and chlorine, carbon monoxide and hydrogen fluoride, ammonia and nitrogen oxides. So tell me which combination or the reaction of which of the compounds causes photochemical smog. Not getting reply. A. Okay, let's see. Anybody else? Any other answers? C, A. Okay, let's see the answer. Answer is A. Photochemical smog, it's a mixture of pollutants that are formed by the reaction of nitrogen oxides and volatile organic compounds with sunlight. It occurs more often in summer. Did we discuss about two cities also? Los Angeles and London. So, London smog and Los Angeles smog. So, please revise it again once more. Okay. And most of you have given the right answer also. Now, in which part of India the tropical western ghats are situated? Very easy, and also very recently there was a news related to the tropical western ghats because of, I'll just give you a clue, because of a plane crash in one of the places. So there was a news related to this. So can you give me the answer in which part of India the tropical western ghats are situated? So nobody has a confusion, I think. B, Kerala. B. Okay, B is the answer, Kerala. So the tropical western ghats are situated in the state of Kerala, but here more important is that you need to understand which are the states which share the western ghats. The tropical western ghat covers the states of Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Goa, Maharashtra and some part of Gujarat as well. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 tropical western ghats, it is shared by 6 states in India. A previous year question was there regarding the states in which the western ghats are situated. So there are 6 states which shares the tropical western ghats. So these are the states. So these are the questions that I wanted to discuss with you. So yeah, I hope this was a very good experience for you. Please let me know how was the test for you, the overall experience. Please do let me know in the comment section. And tomorrow we will start with unit 5. Okay, so I'll wait now for 1 or 2 minutes because I need to know how did the test go for you. So overall experience, you can share it in the comment section. Accordingly, I will also frame the questions from next time onwards. So you can give me your suggestions and comments and your experience in the comment box now. And next time, maybe after finishing like the next, like tomorrow we will start with the 5th chapter, 5, 6 and 7, 3 more chapters to go. So after finishing them, we will take up the test again. We will cover all the previous year, 10 years questions from this particular unit so that you will have a experience with how the questions are being asked, and we will cover all the topics also there. So like this only we will do, like question discussion, and then and we will see the answer, and then we will discuss the answer, like the points and related things we will discuss. So tell me how was the test for you, and did it help you, and give me suggestions also if you have any. Sheila is asking me unit 5, I mean not unit 5, actually chapter 5, actually unit, we are taking up unit 9, no, now people development and all. So unit 9 we are taking up, and in this unit there are basically 7 chapters to be covered, out of which we have already covered 4 chapters. So we have 3 more chapters to go. So next one is the 5th chapter. Tomorrow we will start with the 5th chapter. Okay. Test was nice, getting new information, very useful. Nice, thank you for live, thank you so much. Nice, most of the questions I was able to solve. Very good, Pooja. Test was nice, it's nice experience to attend online. Okay, thank you so much. I'm so happy to get your positive feedback and comments. Thank you so much. After every chapter we will see, because I think your exams will be in November, so maybe we will finish off the next 3 and then we will have a test, or if possible in between also we will take up some test. Don't worry about that. So we have just 3 more chapters to go, and they are not very big chapters also. I think we will be able to finish it in another 10 days, the 3 chapters. And then we will even plan about taking 2 sessions a day. That also we will plan. Okay. Okay. Tomorrow we don't have a test. We will continue with this unit 9. Tomorrow we will take up the 5th chapter. 5th chapter from this unit 9. So tomorrow also the same time, 7 o'clock. We will meet at 7. Okay. Okay, so thank you so much everyone. Even I'm very happy to get your positive feedback from you. Thanks a lot. I'll meet you again tomorrow, 7 o'clock. Same channel, same time. I'll meet you again tomorrow. Take care and also study well. Prepare very well. Exams are near. Like, it's just like, it's already August. So September, October, and 2-3 more months to go. So prepare really well and make sure that you are revising whatever we are learning in the class. So stay safe, stay blessed. Thank you so much. See you again tomorrow. Bye.